notice something important that we sometimes skip over because it's right at the beginning of the article. Article 27. It begins with the words, "We believe and confess." We believe and confess. These articles are articles of faith, brothers and sisters. And what is the nature of faith? Well, faith is not sight, right? We walk by faith and not by sight. Faith is believing that God has created the world and we weren't there and we don't know how he made what's visible out of what's invisible, but we believe it. We don't see it. And that's the same thing here as we talk about the doctrine of the church. We don't see the church as one holy Catholic church. We wish we would. I hope we desire that. I'm sure we do. But when we look at the church, what do we see? A fragmented church, a weak church. And maybe, just maybe, we're tempted to wonder at her ability to persist. Can the church really prevail and persist through the ages, through this age? But here we need to have faith. Faith in the greatness, first of all, of our God and Father. Our God and Father who, remember the people who were not the church in Genesis 11, he dispersed them. Yes, he confused their tongues at Babel so they would not make this vanity project, this Tower of Babel. But even though he did that, that God who did that, who created us, his desire has always been that we would be one. Again, John 17. That we would be united in praise to him as one body, members of his one family, just as he is one with the Son and Spirit, one God and Father who is over all and through all and in all. That's his desire. And in Christ, this is a reality. And so we need to have faith in the greatness of God our Father. We also need to have faith in Christ. The Belgic says, the church has always existed and it will last until the end. Why is that? How can we be sure of that? Because it's his church. Because it's his church. He is the head of the church. He is our king and he is victorious. And so the church will be victorious. And so throughout the Roman Empire's great persecution in the earlier days of the church, throughout the corrupted traditions of the medieval age, throughout the so-called post-Christian world that we live in today, that's how people like to call it, the Church of Christ remains. I believe the Church of Jesus, we sing, holy Catholic remains. We are one through all the ages, the communion of the saints. It's true. And one day we will all stand before the throne, beloved, as one body, made up of a mass of people from every tribe and language and nation, praising our God for his full salvation.